Okay, hello and welcome to the May 2015 FAFL General Meeting. I'm Brian Shadowwolf, and here are pretty much the topics we're going to go over tonight. I'm going to kind of talk about my origins, kind of where I came from, and kind of how I got into the fandom. Next, it's pretty much going to be, I'm going to go why some people are asking, where are the stats? Where's the tackles? Where's the behinds and that? Well, I'm going to pretty much tell you why there aren't any stats and maybe some things we can maybe work on. There's some talks for the next season, like expansion teams, if we get any, what will be affected by joining the FA Universe, and the trade and draft rules. There'll be a few other things, and then there'll be a Q&A at the end. So, let's get this kind of underway. Shall we? Okay, I did join the furry fandom in June 2014. I mean, I have been kind of watching it a bit before then, but I mainly joined it then. At first, I was pretty much just watching whoever really I could find. I mean, I really didn't really have much to do, so I did find the FBA. I was kind of watching that. I did submit 3 players in the 2014 FBA draft. The names of the players were, I believe, Jordan Marks, Sam Elliott, and Debbie Michaels. They didn't get picked up, and in hindsight, I can kind of see why. They weren't really that interesting, really. So, pretty much, I kind of, I was kind of more, well, not ex. I was. Let me just think. Yeah, I was kind of a bit disappointed, but I was fine. I was fine. I mean, only a few people can get their players in for the FBA anyway. So for a while there, I was trying to think of various things to do in the furry fandom. I was thinking about writing. I couldn't really focus on doing one story. It was just kind of I had a hodgepodge of ideas, and I just couldn't really get them to work. I thought about maybe fursuiting, but that would mean I'd actually have to get a fursuit, and I don't really have the money for it. I tried thinking. Well, really, that was kind of it. I mean, I'm not that good of a musician, and trust me, I am not great at art. Just don't ask me to draw anything, that'd be horrible. Anyway, in October 2014, I was thinking that I pretty much came up with the idea that maybe we could have a furry football league. I mean, we haven't seen something like that before. I mean, I've seen all these sports getting them. Like we have the FBA, we have the UFFL, we have the FHL, we have the FLB, and we even have Fur Car and Furry IndyCar. I mean. Really, that they can get a furry league? Well, I kind of thought that, well, why don't I come up with the idea for a FBA like league with essentially probably my favorite sport since I can remember. I have literally my first memory of being a footy fan is back when I was 5 and choosing between who would win the 2004 grand final. Would it be Brisbane or would it be Port? I ended up picking Port and I ended up being right about that. I mean, some people. I mean, that's a good one. Well, I mean, since then I've pretty much been a fan. I mean, I've had a membership with Collingwood between 2005 to 2009, and then finally back again this year, and a membership for Geelong since 2013. Yeah, that's when they put in the lights. So. 2013. So I decided to create the FAFL, and that pretty much the rest is history. You would pretty much that is pretty much history. I mean, you pretty much know. So that's pretty much a bit of my origins. So let's get on with the first subject of the night. Where are the stats now? Gru and Kutsi have asked me, how come we don't have any stats when I post the match? Well, there are lots of problems with our current simulation engine, AFL Live 2. There is stuff where substitute players will act like interchange players. And yeah, that stuff like that. I mean, you've got that. I mean, let's see, what else is on top of my head? You've got. Okay, just excuse me. You got Well, actually, I think the main problem is that I have actually, I mean, the game provides very accurate goals, like the amount of goals. It's very accurate in the amount of goals scored, but with behinds, it's absolutely absurd. Like, I've gotten matches where teams have scored two behinds, three behinds, one behind, and matches where teams have even scored none. So I have had to go in and actually manually edit the behinds. I mean, this hasn't affected any match because pretty much every match has been pretty much teams have won by goals and that, so it's been easy. And okay. I can try and provide a sample of the simulation running, Gru. I mean, I can do that. Just I'd have to do it after the after this, but I can do it. Anyway, pretty much, AFL Live 2 has a lot of flaws. But I have managed to find something that could pretty much fix most of them. I have found Footy Fanatic FX. What about the draws with FX? The first one was pretty much the result was so poor, like it was very, very poor that I just felt okay, I've either I would probably either A have to do it again or B make it it's been well or just make it a draw and like I was it's a bit hard. But the second one, yes, that was actually a draw. And to get the votes for the CW Willing Trophy, I had to go into overtime, and that ended up a draw as well, so I had to go into double overtime, so that just took longer than it needed to. Which kind of brings me into my next point. It takes 1 hour to do an FAFL match in AFL Live 2. I have to sit through an entire match, taking down injuries. Taking down injuries, yeah, and pretty much trying to type up the scores in that. In Footy Fanatic FX, it would probably take 5 minutes. It's that quick. Okay, this would kind of really help the league, as pretty much it would be quicker to do matches and get them out there. I would also be able to do the stats there because after an FAFL match and AFL Live 2, I am just essentially trying to just get that out. So I'm just trying to, okay, trying to go, okay, who's the best in this category? Okay, it's Van de Beek. He goes in here. Okay, who's there? Oh, it's Westwood. Stuff like that. I'm just going for the main stats and finding the best. In Footy Fanatic FX, I would be able to go, okay, the match is done. Let me go through all the stats. Let me type them up, and then let me post them. It would be simple as that. Though there are problems with Footy Fanatic FX 2, not really in the simulation part, but in trying to get the stuff working. For example, the editor crashes whenever you don't do something right. Like, you have a stat and it's not right, it just crashes. It just goes ding and just it's pretty much gone, and then you just gotta start over again. That can get really frustrating. So, if we were to switch over to Free Fnatic FX, it would take a while. That being said, do you guys want to keep AFL Live 2 or want to move to Free Fnatic FX in the future? Still kind of waiting on the results here. Yes, I did test QWERTY, and I just personally felt Free Fnatic FX was a better engine, in my opinion. I mean, if we were to use QWERTY, we'd have to go down to 2 on the interchange, and it would be quite a bit of a fuss trying to get to swap out players and that, because you'd have to create two different lists, senior and reserves. So, I personally more prefer Free Fnatic FX because it's simply just easier to move the players in, so to say. So, pretty much there. So I'm still kind of waiting here. Okay, so well, just kind of waiting here. I'm just gonna check something. Okay, Guru. Yeah, I have been thinking about moving to Free Fnatic FX next season because it would really kind of help out. I was also kind of thinking about having Free Fnatic FX do most matches and maybe down the line doing a match of the week thing using AFL Live 2 or AFL Live 1. Or maybe even AFL Live 3. That could be out by then. I don't know. I mean, they haven't announced it. No question. How would it change the consistency of the results so far? I would say it's Free Fnatic FX would still be consistent with AFL Live 2, at least the results I've posted. I mean, it would be pretty consistent with that. I mean, most of the stats in that, you pretty much can tweak them the same way in AFL Live 2, so I would say they'd be pretty consistent. Yes, player stats would be the same. Yes, that's pretty much their ability. I'm kind of sorry there's a bit of a lag between answers here. We've got about, I think, a 45-second delay here. So if you kind of want to move on to the next thing, just comment, okay? I mean, you're pretty much the only one here, Gru, so you can pretty much just tell me. Okay, this point. Well, I've just gotten a message from Pascal saying he sends his apologies. So I suppose we'll move on to the next thing. Talks about this for next season. Next, not this. It's naturally start, but is there enough room for expansion teams at the moment? I mean, we've got a couple of. We've got a couple of, well, coaches here, but do we have enough to continue with expansion teams at the moment? I mean, we've got a couple of people, but will they want a coach? I don't know. I mean, it would have been good if a few other people would have been here to kind of at least talk about, but hey, I mean, we got Guru here, so we can just kind of see what his opinion on it is. So, do you think there's enough room for expansion teams at the moment, or should we just continue with the eight next season? Another question would pretty much be, what will be affected by joining? What will be affected by joining the FBA universe? And from what I can say, it would really be very minor stuff. I mean, all that would really be affected would be. Excuse me. All that would be affected would be just the sponsors on the jumpers and just references to the AFL on that. That's all you. So I'm just gonna say that not much would really be affected. All we'd really need to do is just draw up a couple of our own sponsor logos and just put them on the jumpers, and that's really it. So, how will the trading system work? Well, at the end of the year, the way I think the trading system is going to go is that essentially you've got one. You can trade one player for one player. Two players for two players, three players for three players, and essentially you can trade your draft picks. So essentially, pretty much, just try to keep the trading even. And if there is an expansion, will the file series go from a file 4 format to a file 5, file 6, file 8 format? It would really depend on how many teams come into the league. If we got maybe one more team next season, no, the final series will still be a final four format like this year. If we got two more, however, yeah, we'd go up to a final five in that. So it really depends. Down the line, we probably will be doing final five, final six, final eight, four format. But at the moment, we're gonna be practically sticking to the Final Four format. And let's see what's been commented. Ghost Lore and see what happens about the expansion. Okay, and I'm guessing it would take a while to get all the players into 40 Fanatic FX, so I would take a while to compile the players into the system. Well, that's what I'm practically going to do. So, let's go on to addendums. Well, how the state of origin selection will work is essentially as follows, as you'd probably know. The players who play who are from that state can be selected for that state only. That's a basic. Don't know that, but it's gonna really come down to. Have you gotten the player details into Flea Fnac FX? I am starting to. I have gotten all the players for Adelaide in. Well, not the stats, but I have gotten the names and the team name. So I'm slowly getting that done. Anyway, how the State of Origin selection will work is that it depends on how many games you've played and how well you were in those games that you played. So, for example, let's use Victoria. At the moment, you've got two guys who could get the centre forward position. Forsyth from Hobart and Konara Komtachi from Werribee. At this rate, Konara would probably get the spot as he has played the most matches out of the two and he has been probably the most effective out of the two. But that's mostly only because Konara has played pretty much the entire season, and Forsyth by State of Origin will probably have only played one game. So, essentially, Konara would get the centre forward position. Anyway, call for stories and artwork. Well, I kind of appreciate if I could get a few more stories and a bit of artwork for the FAFL. It would kind of add more, well, substance to the postings of just match, 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 match. I mean, I've seen some of your guys' stories that you've given to me for, well, the interview stuff for the FAFL 360, The Rising Star. I really enjoyed reading that. I'd like to see more of that. I'd like to see more stories about these players. I would. I'd love to see them. I mean, I'd love to see some more stuff on Rupert Meerat. I'd love to see more stuff on Bayako. I'd love to see more stuff on Konara Komtachi. I'd love to see more stuff on those guys. I'd even love to see some stuff on some of the guys on your team list that haven't really gotten any backstory in that. I'd love to hear just a little bit of backstory for them. Makes them a bit more interesting than player number 5. Anyway, upcoming stuff. Let's get up the fixture. I've been considering getting a lot of orange players. Well, if you want to go ahead with that, Gru, go ahead. I'd really like to see that. I mean, if anyone out there wants to consider getting any art for their team players, I would appreciate that. I mean, it's your decision, but I'd appreciate that. Anyway, let's get the fixture up and see what's upcoming for the FAFL. Well, okay, coming up this week, we have LA taking on Frio. Orange take on East Sydney. I probably know who's going to probably win that and get their 8 in a row. Melbourne versus Gold Coast. That's kind of be an interesting one there. I mean, Melbourne haven't really won a game in the last couple of weeks, and Gold Coast are currently on fire. So, if Melbourne win that, they get a bit back into contention. Gold Coast win that, they can pretty much continue with their dominance of late. And Werribee versus Hobart, is going to be a big match for Hobart right there, and Werribee, because, well, Hobart actually defeated Werribee last time they met. Werribee are going to want to get revenge, so that's going to be interesting. The week after that is the Queen's Birthday round. We've got a special Monday match on Queen's Birthday between Melbourne and Werribee, kind of taking the place of, well, the AFL's Melbourne and Collingwood. We've got the Indigenous round that's coming up in round 11. We've got State of Origin coming up at the end of June. We've got WA taking on Tasmania, South Australia ACT taking on Queensland Northern Territory, and the big one, Victoria versus South Australia. The week after that, we've got a split round, and that's really all the news we've got at the moment. I mean, there's really not much. Melbourne and Hobart have a Hobart. Close that gap against that Gold Coast. Yeah, I would pretty much say that. They have got a bit of a hard road ahead of them. They've pretty much got a hope that they can win a lot of matches and Gold Coast start losing form. That's gonna be odd. Even if Gold Coast still have their form, there probably won't be a chance for them. So pretty much like that team that's just outside the eight that just needs all the pieces of the puzzle to fall into place for them to get into the eight. So there. Okay, we've got a Q&A coming up. So, Gru, if you've got any questions, another a few other questions you want to ask, I can answer them right here, right now. Are there enough players go around for the State of Origin? Yeah, there is. I mean, we have managed to get enough players to go around. I mean, with Victoria, you've definitely got more than enough. Others, they've just barely got enough, but there's still enough to go around. I mean, I guess it would mean for the. Well, the R states have about, well, more than the average FAFL player list, so don't worry about them. They've got enough players. I mean, they have enough. Unless there are a huge amount of injuries for one state, that this should be enough. Do we have any other questions? Any other questions? I'm pretty much gonna be here for a bit here. Just okay. Trying to think. Okay. Well, one thing I also want to put out there is that Down the line, I'm hoping to find some of you guys who might want to commentate a few matches. I mean, that would be kind of cool to do. I mean, I wouldn't mind having maybe one or two of you guys in a match just watch the match and we commentate on it. Like, I mean, I wouldn't mind doing that. I mean, Buck Harper does that for the FBA Courtside Live. He plays team at, and you know, he gets another person to do maybe Jimmy the Intern or even other players, so I wouldn't mind doing that. But before we can do that, I'm kind of gonna need to get maybe a better capture card than that. I do have one, but it wouldn't be optimal for the FAFL, if you get my drift. Any more questions? Any more? Because it would be interesting. Well, it would be. I mean, I wouldn't mind doing a match or two. I mean, it would be interesting. I mean, we'd be able to bring in some more characters. Like, we could have a few commentators. We could have maybe a coach or a player being color commentator for the day. It would be very interesting to see what happens. Many of these matches have been crying out for interesting gameplay. Well, yeah, pretty much. I mean, it is kind of hard to try and put pretty much how a game went into essentially a summary of what happened, pretty much a summary of scores and best of and stats and that. It is hard. I mean, you just look at lots of a lot of terrible, ugly weather football. Reminds me of a match that happened in '99 between Port and Richmond that has the record for being the lowest scoring match between two teams. They both scored around, both teams scored 30 points. You can pretty much find the first 5 minutes of it on YouTube. And if you're interested enough, you can buy it on Name a Game. I don't really know who would be really interested in, except people who really want to say, I own the match that had one of the lowest scores of all time. Yeah, we have had a lot of comebacks as well, and we've had draws, yeah. So, I mean, another thing, we have currently got a work in progress FAFL wiki at, I'm assuming I got a message falls on the ground. I can remember a Geelong Brisbane game from a few years ago having huge puddles, yeah. Anyway, back in the FAFL wiki, it's currently a work in progress. But slowly we will be getting stuff up on it. So, excuse me, bear that in mind. Actually, we've got quite a few things in a work in progress. Mainly the wiki and the transfer to the new game engine. Yeah, no, it's weird. Yeah, I've kind of been busy with a few other things as well. I mean, it is, when you've got a bit of a life outside doing stuff like this, it is always kind of hard to do stuff, but We have currently gotten the LA page up and the player list from there with all the numbers and that. Hopefully we can get the rest of the ones up and then we'll get the players up and we should be fine for a bit. I mean, we'll be adding season stuff, but we mainly have to get that stuff up first. Anyway, I think it's been about 45 minutes since we started. Still looking for a few more questions. If you don't have any questions, then just I'm not sure of the Orange history yet. Have any coaches been with team submissions? Submitting the main teams have been fine with. Team numbers we've only really gotten, well, Orange and Adelaide. I've still yet to do mine, but I've been waiting for everyone else. Kenku has been struggling with Melbourne. Kanaro just said, make Kanaro come tatchy number 9. I don't care what the numbers the other players get. With history though, we have gotten Werribee. I haven't exactly asked for much of the history on the others, but I kind of have a main idea of the league. It probably, from where I'm going, it's probably the in the backstory, the league would have probably started in 1975, as pretty much all the state leagues came together to think we need to make this game national, otherwise it isn't gonna survive. So they come up with the idea of the FAFL. So pretty much they start picking teams from areas like, I mean, they'll pick, I think, Werribee. Oh, did Dyson. Not that I know of. I mean, if he contacts via for affinity, I can kind of check with that. If he's curious, just tell him to contact me, and I'll see what he's interested in. I can see what I can do for him. I'm always happy for someone else to come in and help out, and maybe put in a team maybe next season. That I would really. If he wants to do that, then that's fine. Okay, I think I'm gonna keep. We'll keep going for another 15 minutes here. If you've got any other questions, and I'll probably end the stream there because we've got about 15 minutes to 9. See, I might actually say who I'm probably gonna tip here. Just this week in the AFL, I might as well. Hold on, I mean, okay. What was with the online history going by the wiki? I guess it was. Well, pretty much, I'm probably going to say that Adelaide pretty much were picked for the SANFFL decided that Adelaide would be the best squad out of the SANFFL to go into the league, so I decided that they would be taken to the they would be. Pretty much, well, they would go up to the FAFL when they played their first season, and by 2013, it started to see a lot of financial kind of cracks. Kind of poured a few years ago. They were kind of a financial strait like that. And pretty much, as you know, they were pretty much would have been were practically saved by an investor, and they just pretty much continue on as they are now. Just something like that. Okay, while I wait here, I'm just gonna say my tips. I'll probably put them out once I'm done with this. I'm probably gonna pick Sydney. Okay. Yes, do you smoke? Things. Well, it kind of did. At the time I did it, I didn't know if the because at the time I did it, we had already had we were go, I was going to have the this was right after I decided to go against the 16 clubs established in 1897 thing. So I thought, well, this league probably will start off as maybe a new league, and then when I kind of got the backstory from Canaro, his team had a backstory where the team entered the FAFL in 1975, so I had to pretty much went, okay, that kind of seems like a better idea, though. Well, yeah, it is better a bit, though I probably need to update that logo a bit. Well, they're all something else. I'm gonna pick. I'd probably pick Hawthorn Gold Coast in that match. That's a no-brainer. Probably Port in the Port Adelaide Melbourne match. Probably GWS out of the GWS Bulldogs match. Probably Richmond and Essendon, and just the way they kind of play, they always win the matches that they shouldn't win and lose the matches that they should win. Freo out of Adelaide and Freo, St Kilda out of Brisbane, St Kilda, Collingwood out of Collingwood, North Melbourne, and Geelong out of Geelong, West Coast. Any more questions, crew? Any more? Any more? At this point in time, if there were more people here, I'd kind of be expecting a few more questions, but well, you gotta start somewhere with these general meetings, I guess. At least, one point earlier, I thought I wasn't even gonna be able to do it. I think that's all I can think for now. Okay then. I'm actually we're going I'm going to wrap this up. Thank you, Guru, for actually able to be here. I will be posting this up later on the FAFL YouTube page for the people who weren't there to be able to see it. So I'll see you guys next time, and hopefully we can get maybe more than just Gru, but hey, I appreciate Gru, I appreciate you taking time out and taking time out of your busy schedule and being here. I really appreciate that. Anyway, Brian Shadowwolf signing off.